From Barbie to R&B, Alexandra O'Neill was one of the most successful R&B artists of the 1980s. But after 5 decades in the business, he's embarking on a farewell tour.
The show will celebrate his incredible career, ending in a performance at the Royal Albert Hall next June. Let's have a listen to some of his greatest hits.
That's the way to start a Monday morning.
Yes, it is.
Alexandra O'Neill is here with us on the sofa. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Lovely to have you here.
It's great to be here.
Farewell tour. Really? This is it?
This is it. You know, I mean, after 48 years in the music industry, you know, I want to see if there's some other things that I can do in my life before it's too late, you know.
What would you like to do?
Something simple. Nothing with a lot of thrift. Actually, probably... I'd like to try to make shoes.
Okay.
So, you know, I'm going to try something with a trade that I can, you know, use my hands with.
And I thought you were R&B rather than soul. Oh, sorry.
But it's been a great run, 48 years in the music industry. Great fans, great time. But it really is time to say goodbye and time to do something different.
What brought you to this point? Because obviously, you know, you've got all these concerts lined up, the Royal Albert Hall. How did you get to a point where you thought, actually, I'm ready to walk away?
Growing up, you know, I have grandkids and I have a lot of family, and being in the industry doesn't give you a lot of time to spend with the quality time to spend. So now I'm looking at things a little differently because my grandkids are so young, so I would like them to really know who Grandpa is. You know, before, you know, it's too late. So those are some of the things that motivated me even more so to actually give the music industry a pass and try to do something a little different.
This farewell tour has some fantastic dates. You're going all over the country in the UK, aren't you? And finishing at the Royal Albert Hall.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, that's one of the things that is such a privilege to be able to finish up my tour June 24th at the Royal Albert Hall. And what a privilege. You know, I played there before, but I think this time will be real special. You know, looking forward to bringing a big R&B show to the Royal Albert Hall, and it's going to be fantastic.
And you have had, as you said, 48 years of a career. During that time, who are the people that you've met or that you've worked with who changed directions for you or who made a difference to you?
I think that... I've learned a lot in the music industry from females. Gladys Knight, people like Patti LaBelle, who I never thought that I would be calling them my friends, you know, as I grew up on listening to their music. But I learned a lot about the industry from a lot of big female artists, and I think that, you know, it really helped me to sustain my career and over the last period of time, you know.
What a career it's been. I think we've got some footage of you on Top of the Pops here in the UK in years gone by. Here you go. This is how so many of your fans here remember you. What do you think of the music industry today, Alexandra? What is the state of the business?
I think that, you know, I'm so glad that the young artists today, because I often say that the music industry is a young person's game, you know, and so... with them having created all of the things that they've created, the new sounds, the new music. I'm so glad that they've actually found a new direction, certainly in R&B music, with the sound of the new Caribbean, the Caribbean kind of sound, and R&B mixed together. I think was a great blend. And I really enjoy listening to a lot of the new artists. I think that they're fantastic, and I wish them nothing but the best and nothing all well.
Do you think it's a young person's game, though? Because if, you know, we speak to lots of artists here on the sofa, don't we? And I think at the moment there are lots of people who are coming back after years away because the demand is there. The fans want to see them.
Well, I think that, you know, one of the things that is one of the reasons why I love my fans here in the UK and England is because they grow up with you and they also grow older with you and they still come out and support you. And I want to thank all the fans for coming out all over the years, for buying my music, for coming out to the concerts. Actually, everybody in America knows that I have a special passion for the UK and especially England, because they've been so supportive over the years. And they actually told America who Alexander O'Neill was going to be long before he even knew who he was going to be. So for that, I really do appreciate and I look forward to coming out this farewell tour, performing for you guys and giving you some love back. All the love that you've given me over the years, I get to give some back to you.
Of course, one of the problems performing for fans in the UK is the weather. And you performed in the rain this weekend, didn't you?
Yes, I did. I mean, it rained all day yesterday.
It
didn't stop. I thought it would lighten up a little bit, you know, up north, because I used to live in Manchester, not recently. I love Manchester and the Manchester area. Now, I've seen rain, but goodness gracious, all day and all night. And, you know, it was pretty ridiculous. But the fans were so great. They stayed. You know, the people in UK and England, they get prepared for this. They put on their old wellies and umbrella, and they come out to the concerts. Where in America, they just won't come. You know, they're like, it's raining. Girl, I just got my hair done. I ain't going out there, you know.
And how do you manage on stage when it's like that, when it's torrential?
I just stayed the course, you know. I figured out, at least I think I figured out, what I do for a living. What I do for a living is I make people feel good. And I try to give them, that's what I try to concentrate on. Someone who's maybe having a rough day, someone's having a rough life, try to give them a little brighter day, you know, and that's what I concentrate on, is my fans and making them happy.
It's lovely to have you here to reflect and look forward. I have to say, making shoes was not what I was expecting you to say.
You were going to. I'm looking forward to the shoe collection.
Is that a genuine passion? Have you made shoes before?
Actually, you know, I've been procrastinating certain things for years, and now I get a chance not to have an excuse not to do it. Yes, I do. I think that I have a good eye for fashion, women and men. So I would like to get in there and learn how to actually make them, opposed to just delegating decisions. You know?
You can make some Wellington boots as well for this rain, can't you? Alexander O'Neill, thank you so much for coming.
You'd sell a lot around
here.
Yeah, lovely to see you.
Thank you.
And the Time to Say Goodbye Farewell World Tour starts in Sheffield in September.
You are watching BBC Breakfast this Monday morning. It is 8:59.